Completing moss. Your completing moss only comes in when you are calculating the point of indifference, or when you are calculating, when you are selecting the completing moss. Once you have done that, your market supply factors, demand potential, you only concentrate in the triangle. All right? Your IRS, your H, you assume the radius. Then you times your RE, your RF, for example, anchor point. So your RF or anchor point. Your market supply factors and your demand potential only looks at District 1, let's say it's Toa Payoh, District 2, that is Ang Mo Kio, District 3, Novena. So this is your market supply and demand, first part of your project, all right? When you calculate your IRS, for example, you have Bugis Junction. Your C or your H, all right, would be the radius that you assume. You must look at your map critically, right? Don't just use a Google, you can't see much. So let's say your household is 1,000 customer and competing more X, Y, and Z. Your RE will be based on your statistics. And I have students who say, I cannot find the statistics, what shall I do? You can also do primary research. You can do a survey, an online survey, to get the data for your RE, isn't it? Okay, so that is your RE. Your RE can be consistent, you can assume that it's consistent. For example, if you're doing footwear, your RE for footwear. Your RF will be, this RF will be, if you're selling footwear, will be all the footwear shops in your Bugis Junction. You add up, you can actually observe one or two shops, then you combine. Your competing mall, the same process. You look at all the footwear shops in your competing mall. Let's say Harbourfront. All the footwear shops in Harbourfront, you add together. That is your RM. Your IRS will be in dollars because it is your customer times the spending over your RM, so your sales potential per square foot. Your level of saturation, if it is high index, it means that it is understorm. Low index, it means that it is low index, it means that it is overstorm. Your profitability will be low. Alright, so you must be able to do the interpretation for your IRS. Once you move from your first part, you go into the second part of your project. Which is determining your PTA, your primary trading area. How do you determine your primary trading area? That means you look at where are your customers, who are your customers? All right, let's say for example, okay, you find that your customers at Bugis Junction, they are the students. So you spot the schools. They are the housing estates nearby and offices. Which is the most densely populated radius? You zoom in there, then you draw the circle. Your circle may not fall nicely in the triangle, it may be lopsided here, it doesn't matter, or here. But your primary trading area will be the section that falls inside your triangle. Okay, so if your general trading area is too small, your primary trading area will overlap. You cannot leverage much for your first part of the project. From here, you get this odd shape. This is the one, okay? And this is where you can see on this page here. This is your primary trading area. Your primary trading area brings you here. You don't do the grids when you are looking at your general trading area. Your general trading area looks at the district like Toa Payoh, Novena, and Ang Mo Kio. But your primary trading area will be right where your mall is located. Okay, from this radius, you move here. And also, when you look at your checklist, this one, your local demographics will refer to your primary trading area, which is this one. Your local demographics, your primary trading area, this one. All right? Then your traffic flow and accessibility will be your selected mall. Your retail competition will be your primary trading area, this one. Your site characteristics will also be the same, okay? Your primary trading area. Your cost factors will be your selected mall. So that is your checklist. This diagram, all right, and this, they are the same. Only thing is that you have your current store. Your current store will not be your own store. If you're doing Charles & Keith, it will be Charles & Keith plus all the footwear shops in that primary trading area. Available store site you don't need because you already know where your store site is, whether it's Bugis Junction, Bukit Panjang, or 313. Okay, your store should be inside this map here. Don't just produce the diagram, but you need to analyze and explain from there. Okay, so any question, stay back very much.